Listen.
Hi there, welcome to Smart Way of Learning Concepts and Enjoy Learning. The goal of this video is to make you learn or let you know how to fix setup and hold time violations and also some ways to overcome setup and hold time violations. From the previous lectures, we have seen with a clear timing diagrams of what a setup and hold time is and also have seen the functionality of the given circuit. And with that knowledge, we are now going to learn how to fix setup and hold time violations. We have seen all this in detail in the last lecture, so I am not going into it once again. But for the rest of this lecture, we go with these short forms. From the last lecture, we have seen that when input signal is given during first rising clock edge, we get it as output after the second rising edge of the clock. Hence, at first rising clock edge, flip-flop 1 stores the input signal, and at second rising clock edge, flip-flop 2 stores the input signal. So one has to consider TS1 and TH1 at first rising clock edge and TS2 and TH2 at second rising clock edge. Since the input signal is constant during TS1 and TH1, there is no setup and hold time violation for flip-flop 1. To fix setup time violation for flip-flop 2, the input to flip-flop 2, that is D2 signal, should remain constant during TH2, or in other words, any change or transition in D2 should happen before TH2. The change in D2 happens only when there is a change in input signal D1, and the time taken for this change in input in D1 to reach D2 is equal to the sum of TPD1 and TCD. So now it is obvious that the maximum of the sum TPD1 plus TCD should be less than the time instant T minus TH2 to avoid setup time violation. Here we have to find the maximum sum for the slowest possible transition to be taken into account. It makes clear that by increasing time period, it is possible to fix setup time violation. And now to fix hold time violation, D2 should remain constant during TH2. Or in other words, the change in input signal D1 should not reach D2 before TH2. That is, the minimum of the sum TPD1 plus TCD should be greater than TH2 to avoid hold time violation. Here we have to find the minimum sum for the fastest possible transition to be taken into account. If there is no combinational circuit delay, then TPD1 should be greater than TH2. If TPD1 is less than TH2, change in input happens during hold time and then it results in hold time violation. By this analysis, one can note that hold time violation can be fixed by introducing delays in the data path. In the next lecture, we will find the maximum operating frequency of this circuit, beyond which it does not work properly or its output is unpredictable. Thanks for watching the video. If you think my video worth something, then don't forget to like it and subscribe for many more interesting updates. Have a great time.